Typhoon Betty slightly decelerates as it moves over the waters east of Cagayan. Let's get more details from ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Good afternoon, Ariel.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. Typhoon Betty continues to gradually weaken as it continues to move closer to extreme northern Luzon. Betty was last located 475 kilometers east of Calayan, Cagayan, packing winds of 155 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 190 kilometers per hour. It is moving northwestward at a speed of 15 kilometers per hour. The extent of its strong winds reach as far as 770 kilometers from its center. Due to this and its approach to extreme northern Luzon, PAGASA has hoisted wind signal number 2 this morning over Batanes and northeastern Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands. The weather will start to deteriorate in these areas today due to the outer rain bands and strong winds from a typhoon. Wind signal number 1, meanwhile, is in effect over the rest of Cagayan, Isabela, Apayao, Ilocos Norte, Abra, Kalinga, Mountain Province, Ibugao, northern and central Aurora, Quirino, northeastern Nueva Vizcaya, northern Catanduanes, northeastern Camarines Sur, Polillo Islands, northern Camarines Norte, and northern and central Ilocos Sur. Gusty conditions will be experienced in these areas, especially those in the eastern side of Luzon. Scattered rains from the typhoon and the enhanced southwest monsoon or habagat will also be experienced over the rest of Ilocos region, Zambales, Bataan, Masbate, Occidental Mindoro, Palawan, western and eastern Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, and BARMM. Here in Metro Manila, the sun is still brightly shining. There will be some occasions of cloudiness. While there is low chance of rain until later this evening, habagat gusts will start to be felt today. All kinds of sea craft are not allowed to sail over the seaboards of areas under wind signals number 1 and 2. Gale warnings also in effect over the other areas of the eastern seaboard of Luzon, northern and eastern Samar, Dinagat Islands, and Surigao del Norte due to the big waves generated by the typhoon and over the western and southern coastlines of Calabarzon, Mindoro, Marinduque, Romblon, Aklan, Capiz, and Antique due to habagat. Betty will slow down as it begins to recurve tomorrow, Tuesday. It will be nearest Batanes on Wednesday, will begin to move away from the country on Thursday, and even as Betty continues to gradually weaken, it will remain a typhoon until before it exits the PAR on Friday and will head towards the Ryukyu Islands of southern Japan. The monsoon rains from the enhanced habagat will bring heavier rains over Ilocos region, western Cordillera, Mimaropa, and western Visayas starting tomorrow until Thursday, and the western sections of central Luzon and Calabarzon, Mimaropa, and Western Visayas will continue to experience monsoon rains until the weekend. Metro Manila will start experiencing monsoon rains and gustier winds tomorrow afternoon and may persist until the weekend. Flooding and landslides are likely, so please take care and be ready, kapamilya. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Stanley.
Okay, I just would like to go back to the earlier part of that report. Ariel, you were saying the typhoon is decelerating, and does that imply just weakness? I mean, the decrease in strength. What about speed? You said it is also slowing down. What are the chances that it will linger actually in that area for quite some time?
Yes, this is deceleration or slowing down is brought about by its impending recurvature. Just like when you're driving, you tend to slow down when you're hitting curbs. Okay. So this is what's going to happen with Betty in the coming days, especially it's already started. So this means that for the days of Tuesday and Wednesday, most of extreme northern Luzon will be exposed and drenched to the heavy rains from the rain bands of the typhoon. This also means that the enhanced monsoon rains will also be continuously drenching the western sections of northern Luzon and southern Luzon and Visayas.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much, Ariel Rojas, for the weather update. Preemptive evacuations continue in several regions as well, seen to be affected by Typhoon Betty. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council says over 4,800 individuals have been evacuated from regions 3, 6, and Mimaropa. But that figure is expected to rise as data from Cagayan and Batanes come in. The agency also reminds those in the storm's path to remain cautious.
Yung preemptive is a sort of voluntary and yung ano pa lang, depende pa lang sa local local government unit, no? Based sa forecast and then sa risk factor na exposure nila. So, yun nga. Kasi ang nakikita kasi natin ngayon, medyo humina, medyo pa umakyat, kaya medyo nag-aalanganin yung mga local leaders natin. Kaya napaka-importante yung tamang information na makarating sa kanila. Itong ating eastern seaboard po talaga ay very exposed sa entry ng mga bagyo. Hanggang Bicol po yan, in fact hanggang Samar. So itong mga communities dyan, although sinasabi nila palagi na sanay na kami tayo pag mainit, mag-relax tayo kasi lalayo yan, tataas. But you know, hindi natin alam ang behavior ngayon ng weather, no? So napaka-unpredictable po.
The agency adds the Philippine government has prepared enough assistance for those who will be affected by the storm. The Philippine Social Welfare Department vows better disaster response. It says some 800,000 food packs have already been deployed across the country amid the threat posed by Typhoon Betty. A big chunk of relief assistance is allocated to northern Luzon. DSWD Chief Rex Gachalian says the agency aims to ensure the support of national government will always be ready for local government units.
Multiple hubs and multiple spokes. I was saying we created two supply chain lines.
Okay.
This is the first supply chain line. It's government-driven. Warehouses of the national government and the local government put together in a series of networks for logistics management. The second line we are currently procuring, that is going to be private sector driven, meaning we're going to tap into the existing framework of these big grocers because they already have infrastructure.
Areas in northern Luzon bracing for the possible onslaught of Typhoon Betty. Cagayan Governor Manuel Camba says they are prepared for the worst. He says some residents in Santa Ana Town, the part of the province under Signal Number 2, have already been evacuated.
So far, so good. We are prepared for the worst. Every now and then, we have these calamities. In the last 6 years, 2 super typhoons kami, but madaling mag-adjust ang tao eh. Pero we have to prepare better and better and better, learn from the mistakes.
Over in Isabela, some evacuees have opted to return to their homes as the weather in the province remains generally fine. But Governor Rodito Albano III maintains the local government will not let its guard down, especially as the province remains under Signal Number 1.
Naka-prepare pa rin kami at naghahalda para sa kung sakasakali may magyari lalaman din sa bagyong ito. Preparado lang kami dyan. Salay lang kami sa disaster. At least yung mga tao medyo resilient na ngayon.
And finally, in Batanes, some areas in the province are already experiencing winds brought by Betty. Work and classes are already suspended. In Uyugan Town, evacuations are not yet mandatory.
Nung Friday pa or nung Sabado, nagbandilo na talian yung mga bubong at mga bahay ng ating mga constituent, yung mga bangka sa dagat, inahon na po namin lahat.
Typhoon Betty already making its presence felt in some parts of northern Luzon. Let's check on the latest situation in the province of Cagayan. Dennis Datu is in Santa Ana, Cagayan to give us the latest. He joins us live. Dennis, over to you.
Yes, Stanley, weather conditions here in the town of Santa Ana in Cagayan province continue to worsen with the wind getting stronger and heavy rains occasionally pouring down. We saw earlier that the branches of the trees are being battered by strong winds. Because of this, disaster officials are actively patrolling the coastal areas to encourage residents to evacuate while there's still enough time. However, only 2 families have evacuated so far from Barangay Kasagan. Other families went to their relatives' big and sturdy houses to take temporary shelter while the typhoon is raging. According to Mayor Nelson Lubinon, the town has not yet experienced the full impact of Typhoon Betty, but they are already prepared to respond if needed. Mayor Lubinon said that because their town is often hit by typhoons, they are already used to it and know what to do in case Typhoon Betty intensifies. The residents are hurrying to tie down the roofs of their houses so that they will not be blown away by the strong winds that continue to batter this town, while fishing boats have been brought to safer places as the waves are getting stronger. In the town of Gonzaga, 104 families or almost 400 individuals have responded to the preemptive evacuation call from the barangays of Kalawan, Kabiroan, Ipil, and Santa Clara. Authorities in Cagayan assure that there are enough food packs for affected families of Typhoon Betty. Rescue teams along with rescue equipment and road clearing teams are on standby in different towns in Cagayan. For now, all roads in the province are still passable and communications lines and electricity supply are still stable. Because the wind is getting stronger, the rescue teams are now on alert and continuously monitoring the situation, especially in the coastal barangays. Stanley.
Yes, Dennis, just 7 months ago when Typhoon Neneng hit, Santa Ana, Cagayan was one of the municipalities that was hardest hit, at least for the entire province. They're talking about damage to agriculture there as well, aside from, of course, damage to property. What are the preparations as far as agriculture is concerned? What are you seeing?
Okay. Mayor Robinion said when we interviewed him earlier that their primary concern is the agriculture, because most of the livelihood of this town is based on agriculture. The mayor said they have a standby fund to help the farmers in case they will be affected by Typhoon Betty. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Dennis Datu from Santa Ana, Cagayan. We're still following developments on the country's preparations for Typhoon Betty. Let's check on the latest situation up north in Ilocos Norte with our correspondent Rafael Bosano. Rafael, go ahead.
Hi, Stanley. We're currently experiencing erratic weather here in Ilocos Norte. 1 minute, it's bright and sunny. Then all of a sudden, it's raining hard. But it's still business as usual in the province. However, because signal number one is hoisted in the province, those most affected so far are the fishermen who haven't been allowed to sail. This is why some of them have opted to use this time to repair their boats or turn to alternative ways of earning by repairing fishing spears. The Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office reiterates the importance of heeding their advice, as it means not only the safety of fishermen, but as well as rescue teams. They also said that to avoid the isolation of any area that may be caused by landslides, heavy equipment have been pre-positioned in different areas to clear any debris. The PNP and military are also on standby to assist. Right now, we're in the town of Bangi, where 12 families have been preemptively evacuated because they live next to a river. Different municipalities have also pre-positioned relief goods for those who may need it. The provincial government also said that it has over 2,000 packs ready and distributed to different sites. Each municipality here in the province has its designated evacuation center for families, and they also have evacuation shelters for livestock to ensure that they will also be safe from heavy rain and possible flooding. Stanley?
Yes, sir. Rafael, how's mobility within the province? Are people still free to go around? Go from one town to another within the province?
That's right, Stanley. We've been traveling from different municipalities, and there seems to be no problem with mobility. Public transportation is still working. There's tricycles and other motor vehicles that are flying the different roads. And so far, it's business as usual. But again, the PDRMO has reiterated for the public to heed their advice to continue to monitor social media and different platforms so that they may be able to get the latest information on the whereabouts of Betty and how it will affect the province of Ilocos Norte. So far, what we're seeing is that the rain will probably fall hard beginning tonight until tomorrow and possibly until Wednesday. This is based from Pagasa forecast, Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Rafael Bosano. Over 400 families have been evacuated from the municipality of Tudela in Cebu due to possible flooding and landslides. Annie Perez joins us with that story. Hi, Annie. Over to you.
Yes, Stanley, the municipality of Tudela in Camotes Island, Cebu, evacuated hundreds of families over the weekend in anticipation of the effects of the southwest monsoon. Mayor Graham Ancelante announced that over 400 families evacuated from Barangays MacArthur, South Poblacion, and Barangay General since last Friday as prevention to possible flooding and landslide. Most of the families already returned home. However, the latest data released is that there are still 24 families inside the Tudela Civic Center and 4 families at the Tudela Central School. Mayor said that they just want to be prepared even if there are no reports of flooding and or landslides, although the town felt strong winds and witnessed big waves over the weekend. The weather in Cebu is expected to be fair today, and some of the evacuees will be sent home as we speak. However, Mayor Solante said that they will continue to monitor the development of the loon soon. State Weather Bureau in its Mactang station here in Cebu said that there will be scattered rain showers today as an effect to thunderstorms. So far, there are no more cancellation of trips, unlike what happened over the weekend, where some fast crafts were not allowed to sail due to rough sea conditions. Yet, most of the LGUs here in Cebu and even in Central Visayas are still on blue alert or on a state of preparedness until Typhoon Betty leaves the Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest here from Cebu, Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Yes, Annie, what's the advice to residents in terms of evacuation? Because our weather report a while ago was saying we're not to feel the effects of Typhoon Betty until late tomorrow. So you were saying some of the residents have already been sent home. Are they on alert to go back to the evacuation centers as soon as weather conditions change?
Yes, Stanley. According to the local government unit of Tudela, in some areas, they will still continue to monitor the development. And if they notice that there are sudden strong winds or big waves, they will immediately go back to the evacuation center. Because as of now, at this time, noon time, the sun is already out here in Cebu. So they're still trying to see which would be the best time to preemptively evacuate the residents once again if the effects will be felt here in Central Visayas. We were told by Pag-asa Mactan that the effects would not be so from Typhoon Betty, but because of the southwest monsoon that would be what would be told by the typhoon, which will bring about strong winds and rain here in the Central Visayas region. Annie?
All right. Thank you so much for the update. Annie Perez, stay safe. Despite the threat of bad weather, bus trips going to northern Luzon continue. More from Nico Bagsik.
Bus trips here in Cubao, Quezon City, as well as in Manila at the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, bound to north of Luzon, continues amid the threat of Typhoon Mawar in the northeastern Philippines. But the management of Victory Liner, this bus terminal where I am right now, admits that there are fewer passengers than normal due to the typhoon. They also added that they have been in touch and continues to coordinate with government agencies for safety trips of their buses. Their protocols are also in place whenever and wherever the bus trips are affected by strong rains and winds brought by the typhoon. Passengers can also refund their tickets if they have decided to cancel their trips, and they can also rebook without extra cost.
Actually po, sa ngayon po, wala pa kaming cancel trips. Pero po pagka naman po at nagkaroon nandiyan na yung bagyo, eh meron po kaming protocol. One week pa lang ay nagkaroon na po kami ng paghahanda. Lahat ng pong mga provincial terminals namin hanggang dito sa Metro Manila ay may paghahanda na po kami sa parating na bagyong Betty. Kapag ka po naabutan yung bus doon sa lugar na malapit na siya doon sa lugar, ay hinto muna siya sa mga bus stops namin. Kunyari, pagdating po doon sa CCQ, andun na yung bagyo sa parting Santiago, hinto muna po doon, magpatila muna po ng bagyo at makipag-coordinate sa mga government officials, sa mga NGO, na kung pwede nang dumaan, didiretso na po kami.
Saan kami banda na pwede kaming sumilong po kung saan kami kung mayroon man doon na pwedeng mapagsilungan, doon na lang po kami para kung sakaling tuloy-tuloy na lang kami.
Meanwhile, Ninoy Aquino International Airport and Cebu Pacific have also canceled their flights to Surigao, Lawag, Tuguegarao, Hawayan, and Masbate. Some shipping vessels bound to Visayas, Bicol region, and Limaropa have also canceled their trips as well to prevent sea mishaps.
Some passengers awaiting their trips at the Manila North Harbor Port were forced to spend the night there as they await word on whether the ships will be allowed to set sail. Karen de Guzman filed this report.
Many passengers are seen waiting at the Manila North Harbor port today after their trips were delayed because of the Typhoon Betty. Some of them who came from far provinces opted to stay overnight at the port, complaining that they weren't able to receive the notice ahead of time. According to Manila Port Passenger Terminal Officer, there were some technical problems in the ship, causing a CR delay of the trips bound to Cebu and Butuan City today. The operations will start at 9 in the evening and will depart at 4 in the morning tomorrow. Meanwhile, they will also release an updated schedule of trips in the afternoon to accommodate passengers going to Palawan, Bacolod, and Iloilo. Philippine Ports Authority advised all affected passengers to coordinate with the concerned shipping lines for more details.
Metro Manila also ready for the possible effects of Typhoon Betty and the southwest monsoon. Metro Manila Council President and San Juan Mayor Francis Zamora said local government units have prepared equipment to be used in flood-prone areas, as well as aid for families who will be affected by the storm. Zamora adds local officials also need to draw up an action plan to mitigate the effects of climate change.
The climate change issue is real, and this is something that, yes, you're correct, must be addressed. And we really have to look at the future and not just now. So again, this is something that the Metro Manila Council can further study so we can see how we can mitigate the effects of climate change in the coming years.